Greetings. Let's look at another of your posts, brother. The name, title, Jehovah, doesn't exist in the New Testament. But what were Jesus' last words? Elohi, Elohi, lama sabachthani. Let's handle this as three separate points. 1. The name, title, Jehovah, doesn't exist in the New Testament. But 2. What were Jesus' last words? And 3. Elohi, Elohi, lama sabachthani. Let's address this first, although I can barely claim it is even an argument. First, I must address and correct the basic failure you have to understand the situation. Your very statement is in error, and at best, self-deception. At worst, intentional fraud. The name, title, Jehovah, or YHVH. Stop. Right there. Isaiah 42:8. I am the Lord Jehovah, or YHVH. That is my name, and my glory I will not give to another, nor my praise to carved images or idols. That is my name. Can you read and understand plain, simple words, O Muslim? Jehovah is God's name. Jehovah is not a title. That is not ambiguous. There is no uncertainty. Can you understand the word God is a title? Maybe you are trying to insult the name of the living God, Jehovah, dismissing it as a title. This is so simple, there can be no confusion. I am Jehovah, that is my name. But it is hard to know how deeply the lies of Islam are ingrained into you and your intent. Let's move on with your point. I've corrected it to cover your misunderstanding. The name Jehovah doesn't exist in the New Testament. The failure to find a word or failure to use a word should not be taken to mean anything, brother. And there are several reasons why it is a meaningless observation. 1. The New Testament is written in Greek. When text is authored in one language, it is meaningless that words from other languages do not appear. Hebrew words do not appear in Greek text, just as Greek words do not appear in Hebrew text. The words Allah and Mecca and Quran and Muhammad also fail to appear in the New Testament. These are Arabic words and do not appear in any Greek texts of the Bible. 2. The name of God, Jehovah, is comprised of Hebrew characters, transliterated as Yod, He, and Vav. This is an even lower level of detail regarding foreign words. The characters of the foreign word or name may simply not exist in the characters of the language. There may not even be a phonetic representation of the sound in one language in the text of another language. So to attempt any conclusion from the Hebrew YHVH not appearing in the Greek text is intellectually bankrupt. If a missing word is used as a jihad to undermine God's declared name, it must also undermine assumptions of other foreign words, such as Allah, which does not appear anywhere in the Bible, Old or New Testaments. Any claim the Arabic deity Allah is Jehovah has no basis in historical fact or literary standards. The words Allah and Mecca and Quran and Muhammad also fail to appear anywhere in the Old or New Testament. Any assertion or assumed derivation from or relationship to the Judeo-Christian scriptures must be dismissed as malarkey. If a missing word undermines the validity of a concept, Islam creates a tragic situation for itself. The words Tawheed and Jerusalem do not appear anywhere in the Quran. Since the word Tawheed does not appear, by the implied argument, the word Tawheed does not apply, and therefore Allah is not one. Do not speak of the illah of Islam being Tawheed, being one alone. Since the word Jerusalem does not appear, by the implied argument, Islam has no documented claim to the holy city of God, the capital of Zion. The various mosques built after the Messiah walked in the city of David, in Jerusalem, should be abandoned because Islam has no claim in the Bible or Quran to Jerusalem. After all, the word Jerusalem does not appear anywhere in the Quran. But what is the real cause, the genesis of this entire line of challenge and jihad against God's name, Jehovah, YHWH? Islam exists to erase God's name and replace it with a pretender to God's throne. Isaiah 14:12. How you have fallen from heaven, O morning star, son of the dawn. You have been cut down to the ground, O destroyer of nations. In Luke 10:8, Jesus is talking. So he, Jesus, told them, I saw Satan fall like lightning from heaven. From this, we know Isaiah was speaking of Satan. How you have fallen from heaven, O morning star, son of the dawn. You have been cut down to the ground, O destroyer of nations. Here, Isaiah, speaking God's revelation, identifies Satan as the destroyer of nations. You said in your heart, I will ascend to the heavens. I will raise my throne above the stars of God. I will sit on the Mount of Assembly in the far reaches of the north. Satan is the pretender to God's throne. Satan's jihad is to be declared Allah over Jehovah God. Allahu Akbar means Allah is greater. We must always ask, greater than who? Isaiah 14:14, I will ascend above the tops of the clouds. I will make myself like the Most High. Satan is not the Most High God, Jehovah. Satan only claims, only pretends to be like Jehovah God. And this is why Islam and those who submit to Muhammad must wage jihad for their Allah, who is actually Satan, against Jehovah God and his name. Let's look at this from a more scholarly and mathematical perspective. Reference to God and reverence for his name is shown with the word Lord in all caps. Let's look at the word Lord in the Bible. There are 6,781 references, as determined by searching for Lord in all caps in King James versions. This is actually both old and new. 6,106 in the Old Testament. And I'm looking at these searches with a little bit of leeway and margin. That leaves more than 670 uses of Lord in all caps in the New Testament. That means translators, scholars, and other knowledgeable men have intentionally treated words in the New Testament in the Greek with the same respect as the Hebrew name of God, Jehovah. One critical, on-point example we can seek and examine is verses in the Greek New Testament where Old Testament Hebrew verses using the holy name of God, Jehovah, are recited and referenced. For example, Matthew 3:3, "For this is he who was spoken of by the prophet Isaiah, saying, the voice of one crying in the wilderness, prepare the way of the Lord, Jehovah, make his paths straight." This verse specifically recites Isaiah 40:3. The voice of one crying in the wilderness, prepare the way of the Lord. Jehovah is the Hebrew there. Make straight in the desert a highway for our God. So we have Isaiah 40:3 in Hebrew, prepare the way of the Lord, Jehovah. And we have Matthew 3:3 in Greek, prepare the way of the Lord, in all caps. What Greek word appears here? Kurios. Looking at it in place, we can see that it's kurios is the Greek word. The Greek word designated G2962 in the Strong's Concordance. If you look that up, kurios means supremacy, supreme in authority, that is, as a noun, controller, by implication, Mr. as a respectful title, God, Lord, Master, Sir, and it's used in the King James 748 times. So, not able to use Hebrew characters, Yod, He, and Vav, they choose a Greek title word. They have not translated God's name. They have not changed God's name. They have only used his title instead. This is a sign of respect for God's holy name. So the word kurios is essentially the title, God, when used to reference the Most High. So if you are Muslim, a jihad based on the fact Hebrew characters are not in the Greek is a fool's argument. Greek is a different language and character set. The reality is the Arabic words Allah and Muhammad also do not appear in the New or even the Old Testaments. Another Greek word, theos, is also used to refer to God, lowercase g, and when used with the definite article ho, as in ho theos, and I may be pronouncing that wrong, refers to the God. And we see an example from Scripture here. Ho theos means the God. Just like Arabic has Ilah for lowercase g, God, and Allah for uppercase g, God, so too Greek has theos for lowercase g, God, and ho theos for uppercase God. Titles, not names. Realize Allah is not a name, brother. Overall, this argument from Islam and its teachers is intellectually bankrupt, brother. Jehovah does not appear in the Greek, but neither do Arabic words Allah, Muhammad, Quran, Tawheed, or any Arabic words. Wouldn't you rather learn and think and believe the truth? The choice is yours. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.